Hello. It is Sunday, October something. It's about midday. I have exams that I need to start studying for. The final high school year 12 HSC exams. And my first exams are in 2 weeks and I have done nothing. So today I'm trying to plan what I'm gonna do, because in all honesty, I don't really know how to study properly, which is not a good thing. From memory, in any other exam, I've kind of just winged it and made up what I'm doing as I go along and hope for the best. And it's kind of worked out for me, but I feel like in this situation, I might need to plan what I'm doing, or at least figure out what I need to make sure that I know. So that's the plan for today. We'll see what happens this week. At the Copacabana, the hottest spot north of Havana. At the Copacabana. Anyways, I need to clear up all of this mess, because this is where I will be studying. This is where the study magic is going to happen. Surprise! It's a voiceover! So I cleaned my desk, as you can see here, and this microphone is not very good. I apologize, but it's all I could find. So I cleaned that desk a bit, and then as you can see, here is me sitting trying to make a study plan, and it was quite painful. You can see me, the suffering in my face and my eyes, asking for help. It's a sign, but I got there in the end. I finished the study plan, which is something that I may or may not have stuck to in the end. While I'm recording this, I'm actually looking at that paper, and I don't even know what I did with it because I don't know where it is. But there's the quote of inspiration for you all, at the end of the line of studying, freedom's always near. Even my cat over here seeks freedom. Well, that was Sunday. Was it productive? I'd say mildly so. Monday.
Good morning. It is 9:16, Monday. I've had a shower. I've gotten dressed. So that's a start. I'm gonna make breakfast now. And then we're gonna get to studying. Also, fun fact, you are actually sat in the microwave right now. Because there's nowhere else to put the camera. So yeah, breakfast. Meow! Fridge reveal.
I finished studying for the day, kind of. I didn't get a lot done, but I didn't do nothing, so that's good. I've now gotten ready. I've had lunch. I had instant noodles for lunch, very nutritious. And now I have to go. Also, I'm very backlit, sorry. Now I have to go to tap lesson. I have a tap lesson. I'm getting anxious because I've never been to this place before to take the lesson, and I don't want to get lost, and it's a long journey. I'll probably see you when I get back, or maybe I'll film a little bit. Probably can't though, but we'll see. We'll see.
And so I tap danced my way all the way across Sydney on the hour and a half long bus journey. It wasn't great. I had to stand for most of that bus journey. But the tap lesson was totally worth it. It was great. I had the best time. And then Tuesday rolled around, and At this point, I was realizing the mess that I had kind of gotten myself into. I was already in a bit of pain. It was only day 3 of studying, and I'd barely done anything, and I was a bit lost. And there's me asking for help. I still need it.
Hello, I'm back. I've had lunch, now I'm getting ready to go to dance, so I'm gonna
do a little outfit, do a bit of hair, a bit of makeup, and you can watch along with me.
Outfit check. Shirt I was wearing earlier. Purple pants. They are purple.
But that's fine. Everyone needs a bit of colour in their lives. I think it's fine. I don't think anyone's going to care. I like it. I look so fun. I think I look fun and colourful. Yay.
Hello everyone, welcome to my 150 step makeup and hair routine. Today I'm going to be giving you a full breakdown of how to make yourself look absolutely fabulous. So what you do is you put the things on your face with the different tools, then you do your hair, and there you go. And now you look beautiful, good job.
Okay, done. Got a little bit too much bronzer up in here. So now I have like a brown head. It looks really obvious on the camera. It's not as obvious in real life, I hope. I think it's fine. Hair's in a ponytail. Gotta get ready to go and then I'm gonna go.
And that, my friends, was all of Tuesday. I went to dance, had a great time, came home, went to bed. I mean, what do you expect? So then there was Wednesday. Now, I didn't really have a lot of time to film many things. Well, I did have time. I didn't even leave the house. But this was all I filmed, was this very amazing, wonderful time-lapse of me studying in a very orange light. But it is what it is. It does kind of hurt my eyes, but it's minor damage. I studied my booty off on Wednesday. I had a bit of a small meltdown because I was already tired of doing this work and it was only day 4. It was a bit rough. But moving on with Thursday, beautiful Thursday, once again didn't film much, but I do have this wonderful footage, here I am, of me talking to my phone for a long amount of time. It was about a 20 minute video of me talking about bed. I want a new bed in my room, and I was looking at new beds online, and I was gonna try show you a few of them, but I was going on this very long rant because it was late and I was quite delirious. So I've cut it down for you so you don't have to suffer that 20 minute long pain where I'm just talking absolute nonsense. And I'm also in a blanket because I don't even know why I was in a blanket. But anyways, I'm going to show you the things that I was trying to show you earlier. And these are things that I just found online.
First, there was this, like, carriage. I don't know, like, why does anyone have this in their house? Whose house is big enough to even host this? I think that's just crazy. But I do kind of want that. I think that's actually... that actually would make me very, very happy. So if someone could please make that happen for me, that would be very much appreciated. Thank you very much. And up next, I found this also in like kids' bunk beds. The thing is with this, why is the poor kid at the bottom like absolutely buried? And how does the kid in the second bed even like survive? Because if the kid on the second bed falls, he's going to absolutely kill the other child. Also, I feel like the vibe of this, the bed sheets, the pillows with the American flag kind of vibe, is, it just says a lot. And I don't know why this is a thing that someone designed and can be purchased for the public. I don't like that. Get rid of this. And if anyone has this bed in their house or knows someone that has this bed, find that poor third child on the bottom bunk and save them if it's not already too late. And last but not least, the best bed that you can buy, the any money can buy, the best on the market. This is the bed that anyone wants. It's simple. It has everything you want. There's even child included in this photo. Not that that's something I want. Slow your roll on the allegations. But this is the bed I want. This is the bed everyone should have. If someone has a bed like this, invite me over, please.
and I just want to sit on that bed. I just want to see it with my own eyes in real life.
Happy Friday. Guess what? I haven't filmed anything and it's 4 p.m. It's actually 5 p.m. because I've been studying all day. So I haven't done anything interesting at all, except I did walk to Macca's and get a free chocolate sundae from the Monopoly thing, so that was good. I was going to film that, but it is hot outside, and it wasn't a very long walk, so... Anyways, because I've done nothing today that is interesting, I'm going to insert a clip of something, or even a photo, of something that is more important for you to observe. Briefly. Tall and thin and young and lovely, the girl from
Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes... Anyways, that is all I have for you for this week. Sorry I didn't record an actual video of me saying goodbye. I did, and the audio is not in that video for some reason. Anyways, anyone out there studying for exam, I hope you do well. This was quite the week. And thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye!